Well, good morning and a warm welcome to you. My name is Cassandra Matthews. I'm a student minister in the United Church, and it is a distinct privilege to welcome you this morning on behalf of St. David's Queenston United Church. Merry Christmas to you. I hope that many of you have had a beautiful Christmas and that I imagine you still have some decorations up. You might even have some goodies left over, hopefully. There may, if your house is like mine, you might have remnants of wrapping paper here and there. We've just entered in the liturgical year the season of Christmas, and so it is only appropriate that we continue to reflect on the story of the Nativity. And so this morning, we have sort of a unique order of service where we will reflect on the story of Christmas more personally. And so you will see the texts of Luke intermingled with favorite carols and opportunities to reflect personally on what the story means for us and how we may live into that. And so may we now prepare our hearts for worship as we worship Jesus who was born unto us. I'll now just invite Val to come and share a few announcements with us and then light the Christ candle.
Good morning. Good morning. There are a few announcements in your bulletin this morning. First, we wish to thank Cassandra, especially for being here with us this morning. And Anthony, is always wonderful to have you here. And thank you to myself and Nancy for singing today. That's in here. And for, where is our lay reader? I mean our, okay, yes. Thank you, Nancy, for being the greeter at the door this morning. And Bill and Steve for recording our service today. We have continuing prayers for George Dunn, Howard and Elizabeth Wan, Roberta Cheevers, Pat Graham, Ginny Slingerland, Alice Page, Sandy Sinclair, Margaret Ballantyne, Anthony Logan Sicanolfi, Gus Kronos, Paula Chant, and Michael Fisher. Please remember to pick up your offering envelopes for the 2022. They're available now in the Narthex. As a reminder, we are still asking for volunteers to keep the church sidewalk clear of snow throughout the winter season. Please speak to Bill Utting for details. Hopefully we'll never have to use it this year. St. Andrew's United Church in Niagara Falls runs an out of the cold shelter program for the homeless. Maya Gazzard donates to it every Christmas, but there is an ongoing need for wool socks, warm hats, and gloves for adult men and women. If anyone would be willing to support the program, Maya would like to offer to collect donations and deliver them to St. Andrew's during the month of January. That's nice of you, Maya. Thank you. She'll collect them every Sunday in January so they can be left in the office to her attention. Help would be greatly appreciated to help a sister church in need. Also, it was Jesus' birthday yesterday, but there was also birthdays this past week here in our own congregation. Happy birthday to Violet MacArthur and to Esther. She's not here today, but happy birthday. It was also my birthday this week, and happy birthday to all of us. And the flowers on the communion table this morning are in memory of my little Prancer that I lost last year in a car accident. I still miss him every day. And our special announcement is after the service this morning, Anthony has agreed to play the Nutcracker Suite for us. So if you can stay for a little bit after, you are just going to be delighted with that beautiful piece of music. Thank you so much, Anthony. That's it for announcements, unless anyone else has any more this morning. Violet? I forgot Harper has a birthday coming up this week. Happy birthday. How old are you going to be, Harper? 10? Get double digits. Oh my gosh, it's so close to the teens, eh? A very happy birthday. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.
And we light this Christ candle as a reminder of the presence of Christ always among us. May God, creator of the universe, be a light in us today. May Jesus, light of the world, guide our steps. Alleluia, that we don't need to rely on the lighting of a candle to know God's incredible presence with us. And may the Holy Spirit that dances in this flame stir deep within our hearts. Come, good Christian friends, let's rejoice.
Christian friends, rejoice with heart and soul and voice. Give ye heed to what we say. News, Jesus Christ is born today. Ox and ass before him bow, and he is in the manger now. Christ is born today. Christian friends, rejoice with heart and soul and voice. Now ye hear of endless bliss. Joy, joy, Jesus Christ was born for this. He hath opened heaven's door, and we are blessed forevermore. Christ was born for this. Christian friends, rejoice with heart and soul and voice. Now ye need not fear the grave. Peace, peace, Jesus Christ was born to save. Cause you one and cause you all to gain his everlasting call. Christ was born to save.
Let us unite our hearts in prayer. Holy One, as we once again ponder the story of your birth, we see your divine love moving through the lives of the characters in the narrative. Your voice can be heard by the angels sent to deliver your message and to quell human fears. Your presence and provision is evident in faithful and courageous hearts of Mary and Joseph. Your love is in the heart of the innkeeper, offering what he has. We see you in the vulnerability of the newborn baby. We hear you in the sweet voices of the angel chorus and in the surprised voices of the incredulous shepherds. All who saw you on that night held you, O God, in the center of their hearts. And we too want to worship you, hold you, and feel your love to direct all our paths. It is for this reason that we are gathered here. And so we pray, O God, that you would bless this time together. In Jesus' most holy name, we pray. Amen.
Our first scripture reading is Luke 2, 1-4. And in those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea to the city of David called Bethlehem because he was descended from the house and family of David.
In this passage that begins our journey, we find the Holy Family returning home to be where they would find their roots. And so I invite you now, as we consider Mary and Joseph on that journey, to think about the people and places that form part of your own roots. So we will pause for just a moment to that, and then we will sing.
Once in royal David's city stood a lowly cattle shed, where a mother laid her baby in a manger for his bed. Mary was that mother mild, Jesus Christ her little child. He came down to earth from heaven, who with God is over all, and his shelter was a stable, and his cradle was a stall. There among the poor and lowly lived on earth the Savior holy. For he
Our second reading today is again Luke chapter 2, verses 6 to 7. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger because there was no place for them in the inn.
As is often the case, this short little passage has so much in it. We see a mother caring for her child, wrapping him and caring for him and placing him to rest in the manger. And we see that they have been excluded. There was no room for them anywhere but this little barn. And so I invite you now to reflect on times when you have been cared for, hands that have cared for you, opportunities that you've had perhaps to care for others. And then I invite you also to reflect on times when you may have been excluded, times when there was not room for you, perhaps times when you have excluded others on purpose or otherwise. We'll take a moment to knit that story into our hearts personally, and then we'll continue in some prayer. Let us pray, prayer of confession. Jesus Christ, our Lord, you are loving and merciful. As we adore you who came as a tender babe in a manger, let us remember that you grew to become one who challenges us to end divides, to love not only our neighbors, but also our enemies, to turn the other cheek, to feed the hungry and clothe the naked. Forgive us for what is sometimes narrowness of vision on our part. Remembering your humble beginning and gracious life, open us to your grace that we may hear again the song of the angels and respond with a song in our hearts. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Luke chapter 2, verse 8, the shepherds and the angels. In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over the flock by night.
Maybe hard to imagine, but these shepherds were way out in the outskirts, caring for these sheep. And just imagine them under that starry sky all the time, caring for these sheep, hoping for a Messiah, as they would have. Living in a time of occupation, these people would have grown up living sort of under the thumb of Rome. Imagine how their prayers must have rose to God to deliver them. So I invite you now to consider that they are about to be surprised by God's breaking in to their situation in an amazing way. So I just invite you to reflect now on an ordinary situation that you may have that you would like God to break into in a surprising way and support you with.
Luke 2, verses 9 and 10. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people."
These words, "do not be afraid," are dotted throughout the Bible. In fact, more than 365 times are they there. Well, that's once for each day. And so I just invite you to consider anything in your personal life that about which you might be fearful or afraid. Could be, I probably don't even need to give you examples, but could be, you know, the threat of the virus or what have you. And then I invite you to place these concerns now in God's hands. God, who has broad shoulders and invites you and your fears just as they are. And so in the silence of your heart, I invite you to place these fears to God. Let us pray. Holy God, we give you thanks that you are with us, that we are not alone, and that we can entrust you with anything about which we are afraid. We pray that you would give us the strength and courage and assurance we need. We pray in Jesus' holy name. Amen.
Chapter 2, verses 10 to 14. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you, and you will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of heavenly hosts, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors."
Well, I am mindful now that here we are in the city of David. We are in the city of David this morning. How appropriate could that be here in St. David's? Unto us is born this day in the city of St. David's a Savior who is Christ the Lord. I invite you in the quiet of your heart to replace in the city of St. David's. I invite you to say, "For unto me is born this day a Savior who is Christ the Lord." I invite you to repeat that in the silence of your heart to yourself and then we will continue with some very special music. Well, I think that certainly tenderized our hearts and prepared us for prayer, didn't it? That was a prayer in itself. Thank you so much. Let us unite our hearts in prayer. Loving God, as we reflect on Christmas, help us to throw wide the doors of our hearts. Help us to sense the importance of what happened so long ago when Mary was visited by the angel Gabriel. Help us to remember the words of the angels and prophets and teachers of old, celebrating all of the promises that you made through them to us. Help us to take firm hold of the meaning of these things and to know in the depths of our being that even now you are seeking to work in us and through us to fulfill the promises you have made. Lord, hear our prayer. May this Christmas season, God, be for us and for those around us a season of healing. May it be a season of hope and love and joy. May it be a time of true sharing and of rejoicing in all the earth. As our song suggested, may it be a time of true peace on earth. Lord, hear our prayer. We pray too, O God, for the children of the world and all those of tender faith, for all who have no home to call their home, for all who hunger and thirst. Bless the humble and the powerless, and bring down from their thrones those full of pride and those who have become indifferent. Lord, hear our prayer. Jesus, you brought love to all who were unloved, hope for all who had nothing to look forward to, and peace for all who were full of anxiety and cares. May your love motivate us to care for our neighborhood and community, and help us to play a part in helping to overcome many of the social ills that can drag so many into despair. Receive, O God, our dreams of justice, and restore our passion for the world. We pray, O God, for those in need closer around us, for those in need of a tender touch or healing word. We pray, O Lord, hear our prayer. We lift all of these prayers and gather them together to the one who is present and who already knows of these concerns before we can speak them. And we pray together the prayer that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Continuing with Luke chapter 2, verse 19. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart.
Like Mary, let us take a moment to treasure this story and what it means for us personally. And the best way to express our gratitude is by showing our love and expressing gratitude. Now is the time in the service when normally, before COVID time, we would pass the offering plate. But in its place, we give thanks for all who have given to the ministries of this church and all who continue to give to support the ministries in the community. And so there is a plate down at the bottom of the chancel here. Please feel welcome to continue to support the ministries of the church. We'll continue now in some prayer. We're going to sing a little song and then we'll pray over the offering together.
Snow had fallen.
us pray over our offering. Generous God, we give you profound thanks for when we contemplate and ponder your generosity to us, as Mary did. It is so incredible that you would give to us so generously that you give to us yourself. We thank you, God, and we pray that you would bless these gifts in the support of this community, and that you would bless both gift and giver. In Jesus' name and for his sake. Amen.
Our final scripture this morning, Luke 2, verse 20. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, as it had been told to them.
And so, like the shepherds, let us not depart from this hearing of the story unchanged. Let us sow it into our hearts. May we remain thoughtful and reflective through this Christmas season, full of wonder of the mystery that Jesus is born to us. And so let's go and tell it on the mountains. So let us go from this place proclaiming with our lips and with our lives that there is a light that shines in the darkness, and the darkness shall not overcome it. May the love of our Creator God, the joy of the Spirit, and the peace of the Christ child be with you this Christmas and evermore. Amen.
Bless all the dear children.
You guys are a family to me here, and you guys treat me so incredibly well, and I can't thank you enough for all the time that I've been here and for the people that you are. I love being a part of this church family. Thank you, St. David's. Thank you.
that was fabulous.
That was incredible.